With the vast size of the universe comes with it numerous uncertainties. We already have established rules, theories, and laws of how everything on Earth works. For example, because of gravity, whatever you throw upwards must come down. But when it comes to outer space, a lot of the things we deem as normal don't really play out accordingly. As such, the great unknown is home to numerous insane phenomena. Can you fathom the existence of things like stars within stars or planets made of diamonds? No? Well, keep watching this video until the end, because you are in for a wild ride. Number 10. The sun isn't burning. If any of you have been outside recently, you've probably felt the warm rays of the sun shining on your face. But despite the undeniable heat it gives out, this giant ball of hot gas isn't actually burning up. That's because the term burning refers to a chemical reaction involving the rearrangement of electrons in an atom. So the element itself does not change, but the arrangement of its electrons does. However, our sun, which is comprised primarily of hydrogen and helium gases, uses a process called nuclear fusion. That means instead of atoms being rearranged, the very nature of the element changes. Instead of burning the hydrogen, the sun converts gargantuan quantities of it into helium and energy. So much so that it releases approximately 300 million tons of energy a minute, which would be the equivalent to exploding 100 billion tons of dynamite every second, according to NASA. But this immense reaction requires an astronomical amount of heat and pressure, kind of like a star-sized pressure cooker. Except the pressure in this pot is equal to 250 billion times that of Earth's atmosphere, pushing the temperature at its core up to a staggering 30 million degrees Fahrenheit. Number 9. The heaviest thing in the solar system. Even though it's converting more and more of its finite fuel source into energy, the sun is still the heaviest thing in our solar system. And not by any small amount. It holds a whopping 99.85% of the solar system's entire mass. In comparison, all 8 planets combined make up a measly 0.135%. But wait, didn't I say before it's made up of gases like hydrogen and helium? How can lightweight fumes outweigh good old-fashioned solids? Well, the soul-crushing pressure making up this red-hot gas ball condenses most of the particles of the gas together at its core. Though the core makes up just 2% of its entire volume, it has a density which is about 15 times that of lead. This means it makes up an astonishing half of the sun's overall mass. So, while it only has a diameter that's 109 times that of the Earth, it weighs approximately 333,000 times more. Number 8. The heaviest star in the universe. Our sun may be incredibly heavy, but compared to the other stars in our universe, it'd be in the lightweight category. Across the ring, set at the top of the super heavyweight roster, would be the colossal, yet uninspiringly named, R136A1. Though it doesn't sound super imposing, this giant star is estimated to weigh 315 times that of our sun. For some perspective, that's almost 105 million Earths. But what is it that gives this star its super weighty edge? Well, if you were to train your telescopes about 163,000 light-years from Earth, you'd be able to feast your eyes on the horrifyingly named Tarantula Nebula. There, you'd see a brightly glowing Wolf-Rayet star. It's a rare class of star that carries huge amounts of ionized helium, carbon, and nitrogen. It's these super heavy elements that give the giant star its unimaginable mass and intense glow. So intense that if it were compared side by side to our sun, it would outshine it as much as our sun outshines the moon. Number 7. The biggest star in the universe. R136A1 may be incredibly heavy, but it's actually quite small, with a diameter just 35 times bigger than our sun. Although it might be the heaviest star in our universe, UY Scuti is the biggest star known to man. It's so mind-blowingly large that when compared to our sun on a computer screen, it barely takes up one pixel. But if it's so big, how come we're not being constantly blinded by it? Fortunately for our eyes, it's situated in the Milky Way galaxy's Scutum constellation, around 5,219 light-years from Earth. But even though it's so far away, its incredible size makes it stand out from the small cluster of stars it's surrounded by. That's because UY-SCUTY tops out the tape measure with a radius that's a staggering 1,700 times larger than that of our sun's. That gives it a diameter of almost 1.47 billion miles across. So, even if you were to travel at rocket speed, which is a breakneck 4.9 miles a second, it would still take you almost a decade to pass through. Or, if you prefer land vehicles, a non-stop 50-mile-per-hour road trip would see you reach the other side in an inconceivable 3,371 years. Number 6. The number of stars. Counting every single star in the sky sounds like an endless task, but with a little math, it's not too hard to figure out just how long this astronomical mission would take you. Let's start at a galaxy level, our own to be precise. Some calculations indicate our Milky Way galaxy holds between 100 to 400 billion stars. Using that as a jumping-off point, next we need to figure out how many galaxies are in the universe. Seeing as we don't know how big the universe really is, this is a colossal question. However, one astronomer, named David Kornreich, has proposed a rough estimate of around a staggering 10 trillion different galaxies. Multiply that by our 100 billion stars per galaxy estimate, and you get approximately 1 septillion stars. That's a 1 with 24 zeros and a lot of stardust trailing behind it. So, now that we have a number, how long do you think it would take you to count every single star in the sky? Well, assuming you counted one a second, it would take you over 31 quadrillion years to pinpoint them all. Number 5. Spellbinding supernovas. As ethereal as they look, stars don't last forever. And when they die, they go out with a real bang. These astronomical explosions are called supernovas. They involve massive stars, at least 8 times the mass of our own sun, that consume huge amounts of hydrogen at their cores. The energy this produces generates an intense outward pressure, which prevents the star from collapsing under its own colossal gravity. But when the star runs out of fuel, gravity finally wins against the pressure, and the star collapses in on itself. It happens so suddenly that it would be like watching something a million times the mass of Earth collapse in just 15 seconds. But unlike you may have imagined, they don't always explode spherically. For proof, just take a look at supernova 1987A, located around 160,000 light years from Earth. After it exploded in 1987, researchers were astonished to find that instead of the spherical burst they'd expected, the blast had been faster and stronger in different directions. Number 4. Sparkling showers. In some parts of the world, rain is incredibly precious. But on the outer planets of our system, it's priceless not because it's rare, but because it literally rains diamonds. This incredible occurrence starts in the atmospheres of gas giants like Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. All four planets have atmospheres that contain high quantities of methane. During lightning storms, the electrical energy converts the methane into soot, which clumps together and hardens into chunks of graphite. As the chunks get heavier, they're dragged down by the planet's gravity and into the ever-increasing pressure of its atmosphere. While they fall, the carbon atoms are compressed into incredibly sized diamonds, with some of the largest measuring around a centimeter in diameter. On planets like Saturn, these storms are so frequent that around 1,100 tons of these dazzling stones drop to the surface every year. Number 3. The Diamond Planet. When it comes to planets boasting copious amounts of diamonds, the previously mentioned gas giants can all step aside for 55 Cancri E. After the discovery of this super-Earth in the Cancri constellation back in 2004, scientists began analyzing its composition. They estimated that this carbon-abundant planet had a mass 8 times greater than Earth, with a radius only twice as wide. The discrepancy meant that the planet must be made of dense carbon compounds, like graphite, and extraordinarily, diamond. But it wasn't just a few necklaces worth. Scientists theorize that a thick layer of pure diamond coats the planet's inner layers, making up a staggering third of its mass. That sounds pretty valuable. In fact, if it were to be valued on its diamond content alone, it would probably be worth approximately $26.9 non-nillion. That's a 26.9 followed by 29 zeros. Although it sounds like an ultra-wealthy utopia, there's nothing cool about it literally. In fact, the temperature of the surface reaches a flesh-melting 3,900 degrees Fahrenheit. Number 2. The Hexagonal Hurricane. At school, you probably learned that the most amazing feature of Saturn was its stunning set of rings. But if you look closer, you'll see an even more mind-blowing side to this planet, or six to be precise. At the north pole of this serene-looking gas giant, a huge hexagonal storm is constantly raging. It was first discovered in 1988 in footage from the Voyager probes, and additional visits from the Cassini probe in 2004 has revealed inconceivable details about the six-sided storm. From thermal images, researchers estimate it's about 20,000 miles wide and 60 miles deep, with winds whipping around at approximately 220 miles per hour. But how do all these elements fit together to produce a perfect polygon? After all, the universe doesn't normally build in such straight lines. Well, using all this information, researchers attempted to recreate the oddly shaped storm in computer simulations. By adding in small perturbations to the planet's eastward airflow around the North Pole, they found the currents jostled with one another and meandered into a hexagonal shape. Number 1. Nesting Dull Stars. You'd think the universe was big enough for every star to have plenty of space. But according to the Thorne-Zittkow theory, some stars have no personal boundaries. Instead, they exist inside other, larger stars like Russian nesting dolls. As impossible as it looks, there are two main theories that can explain this phenomenon. It begins with a binary system, where two stellar bodies are gravitationally tied together. The more massive of the two stars explodes into a supernova, leaving a tiny, ultra-dense remnant called a neutron star. Over time, the remaining stellar body evolves into a red supergiant and slowly expands. If it does, the neutron star will spiral into the supergiant center, where it will sit in the hot, gaseous shell of its host, a bit like a cosmic parasite. Another scenario theorizes that the energy from an explosive supernova could propel the neutron star into the red supergiant.